1-2, 1-2, 1-2.
Boy, good to see you, my man.
Connor, how are you?
Finally, bro.
Finally in person.
The big man himself.
You're at Bellator tonight. How are you getting on so far?
Very good. So Lee Hammond win, couple of good SPG performances. You know, we had a bit of an upset with, or not so nice win with Danny Neal. But you know, it's good. Good night.
How's the injury? First things first. How are you getting on?
Very good. It's getting there. Day by day. Day by day, I feel better. They're telling me to just take it easy, and you know, but I feel I can go. So I just need to kind of, you know, pull the reins back on my own self. So that's kind of what I'm doing.
How tough is that for you, as someone who's always gone to the next level and tried to push everything? How does it feel for you not being able to do that?
You know, because when I went to training camp, I'd left my children behind and my family behind. So the last time my son saw me before that fight, you know, I was 360 acrobatic martial arts through the air. And then, you know, with the leg break, I was in the chair the next time I saw my son. So I was a bit upset about that. But they got to see, you know, better each time. So I knew that was going to rub off on them the right way. And, you know, it worked out. So I'm happy with it. I'm almost back, and that's it.
What's the timeline now? Give us a quick timeline over the next couple of months. Where do you think you'll be?
April, they said I can spar again, and I can box again, basically. So I'm just going to take it day by day. Hopefully now, once I get back sparring, I'll know weight, I'll know feel, I'll know my own style. You know what I mean? I'm going to develop a different style, I imagine. So I've been shadow boxing a bit lately, and I feel like, you know, I'm just getting the bearings of myself. But I feel good. I'm grounded on my feet. You know, I can stop and start and take off. It's just the little twist or a torque I've just got to be careful on. But this will be here today, gone tomorrow type of thing in my own head. You know what I mean? The bone will recover. It'll connect back to itself. And it'll be like it never happened.
We're here in the Tree Arena. This is the place you came back after you tore that ACL. You came back against Diego Brando. Do you get those kind of feelings coming back from this?
My man, I've shed blood here. Not my own blood, though. Here I am, but I've shed blood. They haven't even got proper 12 on premise. Hit me in the fields that one day. You know what I mean? I went by 100 bars, breaking the heart and all. But, you know, it is what it is. It's great to be back here in the O2. I've been, you know, I watched the last one with James and the lad Peter from abroad. And, you know, the crowd was just so amazing. I've always, you know, it's good to be back here.
Everyone's calling you light heavyweight McGregor here. Because you're light heavyweight.
Light heavy. Yeah, no, I go up and down, I trim, you know, I'm just eating and lifting. And, you know, I'm not having to restrict.
What weight are you going to come back at?
I'm not sure yet, to be honest. I'm not sure yet. 170, 155, 170, I'd imagine, you know. That's.
We see Makachev is fighting tomorrow night. The title fight's coming up.
Who?
Islam Makachev.
Oh, yeah.
The title fight is obviously coming up, Gaethje versus Oliveira. A lot of people are saying
Is it though? It's not announced. You don't know. Is it?
I don't know, maybe.
I don't know either. I've heard, but I don't know. You wouldn't know. Maybe a man, if your man's wise, he might give it another month or two. July seems okay for me. You know, I can't say too early. You know, but July, if I'm sparring April, May, June, July, you know, I could get in and slap the head off most of these guys at the end of April. You know what I'm saying? I mean, your spar could be a fight.
So you think you can come straight back in right into a title fight before even there's another title fight?
It's about time this game starts giving me respect from my different styles of fighting. My ground, my shots downward, my shots upward. You know what I mean? No matter what's going on with the leg, I'd skew into open guard. There's an 11% chance this bone doesn't heal. It's past that now, but there was an 11% chance the bone never heals. It's called a non-union, where the bones don't join. I think something similar is what's happening to Chris Weidman at the minute. So I'd be forever on that stability, you know, instability. But even if I'm past that now, past that stage. But even if it did become that, I'd skew in into open guard and play open guard attacks. People are going to give me my respect from all of the facets of my game. You know what I mean? Even the shots from my downward shots from bottom, the elbows, the up kicks. Even since that fight, you're seeing people trying to implement them and make them. It's not the same. There's levels to this game. So the game is going to understand and give me my respect for my multiple facets to my game.
Is that one thing? Someone asked me the other day, what's the biggest what if? The last thing for me, what's the biggest what if in MMA? And mine was, if you didn't fight Floyd Mayweather. We kind of missed a large part in MMA of your career. It was great for you. You earned a lot of money. Yeah, is that something you want to prove? That you're still one of the best in the world in MMA?
Damn right. I want to compete. You know, I know that. I don't got to prove that. I am that, man. I'm the double champ. I went to the different sport. I came back. You know what I mean? I know that. I don't got to prove that. I know that. Yeah. So it's just about getting back in competing, getting myself into pristine condition and going in and enjoying myself, putting on a show for the fans, you know what I mean? That's it. Once I get the leg cleared and I get that feeling of myself when I kick a body, when I step back in and out, and I get that feel of it, then I'll be able to gauge time. And then I'm going to isolate myself. I'm going to stay away from the pub. I'm going to stay away from my delicious forged Irish stout, from my tasty, smooth, proper Irish whiskey. And I'm going to dedicate myself to my craft 100% and give it a month or two of that and see how everything goes, and then make the move. You know, I'm no hurry, no rush. You know, I know a lot of people are supporting me, and you know, I want to do them well. I want to do my support well, and then that's what we're going to do.
Connor, thank you very much. Always make time for Severe, man. I appreciate it.
Great to meet you. You're a great voice for the sport, and big respect to you, my man.
Thank you, Connor. Thanks very much.
Cheers, pal. Thank you.
Thanks, lads.
Cheers.